حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه كما يحب ربنا ويرضى، وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وبعد. As we began last week, Ya Ikhwan, in the first lesson of our series in refutation of the tabloid culture in light of the Quran and the Sunnah, and we will continue tonight, bi-ithnillahi tabaraka wa ta'ala, to establish the proofs and evidences against this evil culture, Ikhwan, that is spread amongst us. And by the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Ikhwan, we hope to refute that which these individuals are upon. But before continuing, Ikhwan, I wanted to make sort of a statement. As this week I was reminded of a few matters. And I want to make mention, Ikhwan, of what Shaykhuna Shaykh Muqbil ibn Hadi al-Wadi'i rahimahullah ta'ala mentioned, Ikhwan, in his tremendous recording, Al-Hiwar Ma'a Jama'at al-Takfir, a debate with the people of Takfir, where Shaykhuna Shaykh Muqbil, Ya Ikhwan, refuted the people of Takfir and the Khawarij and dismantled their methodology step by step, narration by narration, pulling apart that which they are upon from falsehood and transgression against the methodology of Al-Sunnati wal-Jama'ah. But it was mentioned by our Shaykh, Shaykhuna Shaykh Muqbil, rahimahullah ta'ala, that when you begin to bring these narrations in refutation of the Khawarij, those narrations that mention the rahmah, the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah's forgiveness of the ibad regarding the sins, then you have those from amongst them who will say, these individuals take sins lightly. So we wanted to make mention that which Shaykhuna Shaykh Muqbil mentioned, rahimahullah ta'ala, that we are not a people to take sins lightly. Barakallahu feekum. As how many lessons have we read from Al-Kaba'ir by Imam Al-Dhahabi? How many lessons have we given, Ikhwan, from the tremendous book Al-Dawa al-Dawa of Ibn Qayyim al-Jawziyyah, The Sickness and the Cure? How many narrations have we brought, Ya Ikhwan, in that regard? As Shaykhuna Shaykh Muqbil mentioned, we are doing this because what we are doing is the haq. We are combining between the narrations, between the texts, so as to bring about maximum benefit and understanding regarding the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So let no one confuse you, and let no one give you misinformation and disinformation regarding this matter, that they are making light of transgression and sin against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. La ya akhwan. Rather, we remind one another of those lessons that we have given and call you back to those recordings of Al-Kaba'ir, the major sins, and also that which we have done and other than us in the affairs of Ibn Qayyim and his writings. So we continue, Ikhwan, regarding this culture of the spreading of sins and the spreading of ghiba and namima. And he said, she said, and isha'at al-fahisha fil ladhina amanu, and the spreading of illicit tales of sex amongst the believers. We continue, Ikhwan, reminding you and mentioning to you from the fundamental principles of this deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We are bringing forth the narrations of the Messenger of Allah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the ayat of the book of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. An Abi Huraira radiallahu anhu anna Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qal kullu ummati mu'afa illa al-mujahideen. The Messenger of Allah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, on the authority of Abu Huraira, that all of my ummah is forgiven except those who expose themselves. وَإِنَّ مَنْ مِنَ الْمُجَاهَرَةِ أَنْ يَعْمَلَ الرَّجُلُ بِاللَّيْلَ عَمَلًا ثُمَّ يُصْبِحُ وَقَدْ سَتَرَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ فَيَقُولُ يَا فُلَانَ عَمَلْتُ الْبَارِحَ كَذَا وَكَذَا. In the authentic narration, the Prophet ﷺ, he says that what is al-mujahara, what is exposing oneself, is that a person does a sin by night, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala covers that sin for them. And when they wake in the day, they said, oh, so-and-so, guess what I did last night? Exposing themselves. وَقَدْ بَاتَ يَسْتُرُهُ رَبُّهُ وَيُصْبِحُ يَكْشِفْ سَتْرُ اللَّهِ عَنْهُ. So Allah had covered him by night. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had covered him by night or her by night, and that was they had done from transgression and sin, wa'adhu billah, and refuge is sought with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But Allah had covered that matter by night, and they woke in the morning and uncovered and pulled down the cover of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This narration, ikhwan, is collected by Imam al-Bukhari and Imam Muslim fi sahihayhima. And we will mention, ikhwan, a tremendous sharh, explanation of this narration in a moment, bi-ithnillahi tabarak wa ta'ala. But before doing so, I want to make mention of another narration regarding this affair. وَعَنْ إِبْنِ مَسْعُودَ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ قال جاء الرجل إلى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال يا رسول الله إني عاجلت امرأة في أقضى المدينة. That someone, a man, came to the Messenger of Allah Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, and we know, ikhwan, he is Abu Yusr al-Ansari رضي الله عنه. And he came to the Messenger of Allah Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم and mentioned that he had met with a woman in the outskirts of Al-Madinah. وإني أصبت منها دون أن أمسها. And he mentioned that he had done everything with her except enter her. فَأَنَا هَذَا. So this is my affair. فَقْضِ فِيَّ مَا شِئْتَ. So do with me or judge in my affair as you please, O Messenger of Allah. فَقَالَ عُمْرَ بْنُ الْخَطَّابِ. So Umar said, يَا أَخْوَانِ لَكَدْ سَتَرَكَ اللَّهِ لَوْ سَتَرْتَ نَفْسَكَ. Umar, ikhwan, before the Messenger of Allah Muhammad ﷺ responded, Umar said to Abu Yusr al-Ansari, indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has hidden your sin, if only you would have hidden it yourself. Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had hidden that affair, if only you had hidden it yourself. So here we see, ikhwan, min sabil al-mu'mineen, from the way of the believers. Umar ibn Khattab, ya ikhwan, radiallahu anhu. As we know, ikhwan, itiba' al-sunnah, and the manhaj al-salafi, the methodology of salafiyah, is itiba' al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is following the Messenger of Allah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, was sabil al-mu'mineen, and the way of the believers. As we know from the ayah in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, was sabil al-mu'mineen. And as Ibn Kathir has mentioned, and also as Sa'adi and others, that the meaning of the mu'mineen, the believers in this ayah, ya akhwan, are first and foremost the companions of the Messenger of Allah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So therefore we understand, ikhwan, from the way of the companions, from them in this narration, Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu, that the way of the believers, ikhwan, is satr al-uyub, satr al-dhunub, the hiding of the sins, the covering of the sins. And here we see from the Messenger of Allah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, la inkar. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not refute and negate what Umar had done. Do we not know, ikhwan, that this is sunnah? Then when something takes place in the presence of the Messenger of Allah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he doesn't make inkar upon it, it is known as taqriri, akhwan, sunnah, by the silence of the Messenger of Allah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. For had it been forbidden for Umar to say that, then our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would have had to correct Umar at that moment. It would have been upon him to correct Umar at that moment. But rather the Messenger of Allah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ikhwan, remains quiet in that regard. This also reminds us, and the narration of the Tawbah of Ka'b ibn Malik, the narration of Ka'b ibn Malik, that in the narration, ikhwan, that when someone said regarding Ka'b, that he busied himself with his property and looking at himself and the likes of this, yani that it was Mu'adh ibn Jabal. It was Mu'adh ibn Jabal, ikhwan, who defended him. And he said, بِئْسَ مَا قُلْتْ لَا نَعْرِفُ عَنْهُ إِلَّا خَيْرٌ. It is evil, or it is not right what you have said. We only know good of Ka'b. And the Messenger of Allah Muhammad sakata wa ma qala shay'in. And the Messenger remained quiet and didn't say anything. Shaykh al-Uthaymeen, ikhwan, he explains in the explanation of Riyadh al-Saliheen that this is a proof that that which Mu'adh ibn Jabal done in defense of his brother Ka'b was correct. So therefore, ikhwan, as we see in this narration, with the silence of the Messenger of Allah Muhammad sallam, that what we are finding from it, ikhwan, it's the Prophet's acceptance of that which Umar had done. And in the other narration that we mentioned last week, this happened with when he went to Abu Bakr, and this happened when he went to Umar, that they both told him, if only you would have hid that affair amongst yourself. So after he left, اتبعه النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم الرجل دعاه وتلا عليه هذه الآية. And after he left, the Prophet, the ayahs were revealed to the Messenger of Allah Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. وإن السيئات. Indeed, righteous deeds remove evil deeds. And when it came back, some of the companions said, هَلْ هَذَا لَهُ خَاصَةٌ. Is this for him specifically, O Messenger of Allah? And the Prophet ﷺ said, "Bal al-nasi kafa." Rather, it is for all of the people. This matters for all of the people. This narration, ikhwan, is collected by al-Bukhari and Imam Muslim. From the dangers, ikhwan, of al-jahr bil ma'asi, from the dangers and the evils of the exposing and the uncovering of sins, قال ابن بطال, ابن بطال, ikhwan, he said, fil jahr bil ma'asiya, regarding the affair of exposing one's sins or the sins of others, he said, ikhwan, fi istighfaf bihaq Allah wa rasulihi wa salih al-mu'mineen, that in it, ikhwan, that the exposing of sins, one's own sins or the sins of others, in it, ikhwan, is showing disdain for the right of Allah. It is showing contempt and disdain for the right of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the right of His Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the righteous from the believers. وَفِيهِ ضَرْبٌ مِنْ الْعِنَادِ لَهُمْ. And in it is, ikhwan, is something of obstinance. In it is something of obstinance for the right of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the right of His Messenger and the righteous from amongst the believers. فِي السَّتَرْ بِهَا السَّلَامَ مِنْ الْاِسْتِخْفَافِ. And in the hiding of sins, he says, ikhwan, is safety from showing disdain to the right of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to the right of His Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and to the righteous from amongst the believers. لِأَنَّ الْمَعَاسِ تَذُلُّ أَهْلَهَا. Because sins humiliate the people who commit them. مِنْ إِقَامَةِ الْحَدْ عَلَيْهِمْ. Because of the punishments that are given to them. Imagine now the one who loses his hand. His hand is chopped off for thieving, for theft. And now we find him, ikhwan, walking through the streets without his hand, humiliated. It is a humiliation upon him, ya ikhwan. Humiliation upon him or her. And then he goes on to mention, وَمِنْ تَعْزِيرٍ لَمْ يُوجِبْ حَدٍ. And then humiliation or being rebuked and censured if there is no head, no punishment connected to that particular sin. وَإِذَا تَمَحَّصَ حَقَّ اللَّهِ. So the one who truly sees the right of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, فُوَ أَكْرَمَ الْأَكْرَمِينَ. He is from those who are the most noble and beneficent. وَرَحْمَتُهُ سَبَقَتْ غَضَبَهُ. And his mercy precedes his wrath. فَلِذَلِكَ إِذَا سَتَرَهُ فِي الدُّنْيَا. So therefore Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala covers the believer's sin in this dunya. لَمْ يَفْضَحُ فِي الْآخِرَةِ. That he will not uncover that matter in the akhirah, in the next life. وَالَّذِي يُجَاهِرُ يَفُوتُهُ ذَلِكَ. And as for the one who exposes the affair, then he misses the blessings of that. He misses the blessings of Allah's covering him. He misses the blessings of Allah's satr, of Allah's covering and hiding of that affair. The one who uncovers that matter of himself or the matter of other than him from the believers. Regarding the narration that we mentioned, ikhwan, of the hadith of al-mujahara, those who expose themselves, Ibn Hajr, he mentions in Fathul Bari a tremendous word. وَالْحَدِيثُ مُصَرِّحْ بِذَمِّ مَنْ جَهَرَ بِالْمَعَصِيَةِ. This narration is clear in its rebuking and censuring of the one who exposes sins. فَلْيَسْتَلْزِمْ يَعْنِي مَدْحْ مَنْ يَسْتَتِرْ. And therefore, that necessitates the praise of the one who hides his sins. Why? Because as we know, إِخْوَانْ بِمَفْهُومَ الْحَدِيثِ, from what is understood from the hadith, that the opposite is also true. That the opposite is also true. As we know from the narration, from the ayah in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ya ikhwan, وَمَا يَزَالُونَ مُخْتَلِفِينَ إِلَّا مَا رَحِمَ رَبُّكَ. That they will continue to differ except those who Allah has had mercy upon them. So the opposite of that is also true. That those who Allah does not have mercy upon them are those who do what? Who differ. The Prophet said, مَنْ يُرِدِ اللَّهُ بِهِ خَيْرًا يُفَقِهُ فِي الدِّينِ. Whoever Allah wants good for him, he gives him fiqh of the religion, he gives him understanding of the religion. Shaykhuna Shaykh Muqbil, he said that the opposite is also true. That whoever Allah does not want good for them, he does not give them understanding of the religion. So therefore, ikhwan, we understand that if those who expose themselves, if there is a censuring and a rebuking for those individuals who expose themselves, then the opposite is also true, that it is praiseworthy and honorable and noble, and may Allah protect us from falling into sins, but there is an honor and nobility to those who hide their sins. Huh? So then the Shaykh, he goes on to mention, Shaykh al-Islam, Ibn Hajar, and he says, Ya Ikhwan, وَأَيْذًا فَإِنَّ السَّتْرَ اللَّهُ مُسْتَلْزِمْ لِسَتْرَ الْمُؤْمِنِ. And also the satr of Allah, yani Allah's covering, what it necessitates is the covering of the believer ala nafsihi, covering his own sin, covering his or her own affair. فَمَنْ قَصَدَ إِظْهَارَ الْمَعَسِيَ وَالْمُجَاهَرَ بِهَا أَغْضَبَ رَبَّهُ. So the one who is determined, who intends to uncover and expose his sin, بِالْمُجَاهَرَ, exposing that matter, has invoked the anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon him. Did not the Messenger of Allah Muhammad say, كُلُّ أُمَّتِي مُعَافَى, all of them are forgiven except those who expose themselves. Shaykh al-Urth Aymin, he said, ya akhwan, therefore one of the conditions of the repentance of the slave is to hide his sins, and the one who uncovers and exposes and spreads his sins therefore puts himself under the threat of Allah's punishment and the absence of Allah's forgiveness. So therefore, ya akhwan, this matter is serious with us. And Ibn Hajar is mentioning here, they bring about the threat of the anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَلَمْ يَسْتُرْهُ, and they did not hide it. وَمَنْ قَصَدَ تَسَّتُرْ بِهَا حَيَاءً مِنْ رَبِّهِ وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنَّ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ بِسَّتْرِهِ. And as for the one who intends and desires to hide his sin out of shyness before his Lord and out of shyness before the people, Allah will bless him and hide his sin as well. We also mention, ikhwan, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as we have mentioned, يُحِبُّ السَّتَر. Allah loves satr. Allah loves that the sins are hidden. Allah loves that the sins are hidden, and Allah dislikes that the sins are spread amongst the believers. إِشَاعَةُ الْفَاحِشِ فِي الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. As we will go into some detail later, inshallah ta'ala. قال الله تعالى, Allah says, وَأَسْبَغَ عَلَيْكُمْ نِعْمَهُ ظَاهِرَةً وَبَاطِنَةً. And he says, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala graces upon you with his blessings, inwardly and outwardly, from Surah Luqman. And the ulama have mentioned, ikhwan, from the Mid-Dhahaq, ikhwan, who gave tafsir of the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from the ulama of the past, he said, Amma Zahira, as for Allah's blessings upon us in the apparent way, apparently, he says, ikhwan, فهو الإسلام والقرآن, then they are al-Islam, the ni'mah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon us with this religion, ikhwan. And the Qur'an, this is the haq, this is the tafsir, his understanding and commentary upon this ayah. That the apparent blessing and grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon us is first and foremost, ikhwan, is al-Islam al-Qur'an. Wa amma al-batin, and as for that which is, that inward blessing, or like this, فَمَا سَتْرَ مِنْ الْعُيُوبِ, what Allah has hidden from sins. At the haq mentioned, ikhwan, in the tafsir of this particular ayah, that what Allah has graced upon you from his ni'am, from his blessings, outwardly, ikhwan, it is al-Islam, it is al-Qur'an. And he's mentioned from those matters, as he said, from al-batina, from that which is inward, or like this, he says, ikhwan, it is the hiding and the covering of the faults and the sins of the people. As-satr, ikhwan, huwa min sifatillah. As-satr, yani the covering of faults and the covering of the affairs, is min sifatillahi subhanahu wa ta'ala, from the attributes of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Do we not find, ikhwan, as-sittir, the name is sittir for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, an ya'ala ibn Umayyah, anna Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ra'a ar-rajulan yaghtasil bila izar, fasa'ad al-minbar, fahamid Allah wa athna alayhi, thumma qal, إن الله عز وجل حي ستير ويحب الحياة والستر فإذا اغتسل أحدكم فليستتر. In this authentic narration, ikhwan, authenticated by Sheikh Al-Albani رحمه الله تعالى, in the Sahih of Abi Dawood, in the Sunan of Abi Dawood, Sheikh Al-Albani has authenticated this narration رحمه الله تعالى, on the authority of Ya'ala ibn Umayyah, that the Messenger of Allah Muhammad saw a man making ghusl, and he was not covering himself with the izar. So the Messenger of Allah Muhammad sa'ad al-minbar, he rose upon the minbar, he climbed the minbar, and he praised Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then he said, indeed Allah is hayyun sittir. Allahu Akbar. Allah is the eternal, the ever-living. Yani sittir, the one who covers the faults, the one who covers the affairs of the believers, the one who covers. يُحِبُّ الْحَيَا وَالسَّتَرْ, and Allah loves shyness and covering. Allah loves shyness and covering. So if one of you makes ghusl, then let him cover himself. عَظِيمُ أَبَادِي أَخْوَان, the noble scholar of hadith, in the explanation of the Sunan of Abi Dawood, فِي عَوْنِ الْمَعْبُودِ, He explains his narration, Ya Ikhwan, and he says, regarding the name Sittir, he says, Tariq li hubb al-qaba'ih, leaving off the love of despicable things. Not loving despicable and distasteful things. Sazr al-uyubi wal-fada'ih, covering and hiding the faults and the humiliations of the people. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Sittir. Allah is the one who covers the faults and the humiliations of the people. So if only they would cover their own faults and humiliations and the faults and humiliations of their brothers and their sisters. هذا من صفات الله سبحانه وتعالى. This is from the attributes of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. وأهل السنة والجماعة. As we know from the authentic narration collected by the Imam from the Bukhari wa Muslim. إِنَّ لِلَّهِ تِسْعَةً وَتِسْعِينَ إِسْمًا مَنْ أَحْصَاهَ دَخِلَ الْجَنَّةِ. For Allah, there are 99 names, whoever memorizes them or enumerates them will enter paradise. And as the ulama have mentioned the explanation of this narration, those who give the rights of the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is Sittir. Allah is the one who covers your ikhwan. Covering the faults of the believers. Covering the humiliations of the believers. If only they will cover their own humiliations and their own faults. And then we mention Ikhwan, what Ibn Athir says in his tremendous book, Ikhwan al-Nihaya fi Gharib al-Hadith. And this book is tremendous. Shaykh al-Albani mentioned, rahimahallahu ta'ala, that in the earliest days of his studies, when he was learning the science of Hadith, and he would read through the narrations of the Messenger of Allah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he would come upon narrations that he didn't understand the meanings of some of the words in the narration. And he would go to the tremendous book, al-Nihaya fi Gharib al-Hadith. And Sheikh Nasser said for two reasons he didn't understand a lot of these, some of these words. He said, first and foremost, أَنَا كُنْتُ طَالِبًا جَدِيدًا, I was a new student of knowledge. And secondly, كُنْتُ مِنْ الْعَاجِمْ, and secondly, I am from the non-Arabs. So therefore, some of these words were difficult upon me. An encouragement for us, Ikhwan, as we have said before over and over again, with the learning of the Arabic language. At any rate, in النهاية في غريب الحديث, Ibn Athir, he says, إِخْوَانْ سِتِّيرْ عَلَى وَزْنِ فَعِيلْ. It is upon the scale, fa'il, in the Arabic language. And he says, يُحِبُّ الْحَيَاءِ. He says, are you regarding that? يَعْنِي فَعِيلٌ بِمَعْنَى فَعِيلٌ أي مِنْ شَأْنِهِ وَإِرَادَتِهِ حُبَّ السَّتَرِ وَالسَّوْنِ. That from Allah, from the things that Allah does, from his actions, and from his decree and his desires, is his love of covering and protecting. His love of covering and protecting. From the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ya ikhwan. عن ابن عمر رضي الله عنه أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال إن الله يدني المؤمن, that indeed on يوم القيامة, that Allah will bring the believer close, فيضع عليه كنفه, and he will يعني put him under his shelter, وصدره يعني صدره وعفوه وعفوه, that Allah will put him under his pardon and his covering, ويستره, and he will cover him, فيقول أتعرف ذنب كذا. And he will ask him and remind him, do you remember such and such a sin? فَيَقُولُ نَعَمْ. And the slave will say, yes, my lord. حَتَّى إِذَا قَرَّرَهُ بِذُنُوبِهِ. Until he will continue to be shown his sins. وَرَأَى نَفْسُ أَنَّهُ هَلَكْ. And after he has shown his sins, he will believe that he is destroyed. That's it for him. No hope he believe for himself, he thinks, right? The believer. And then he says, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, لَقَدْ سَتَرْتُهَا عَلَيْكَ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَأَنَا أَغْفِرُهَا لَكَ الْيُومِ. Then Allah will say, indeed I have covered them for you in the worldly life, and indeed I will forgive you of them today. Here we see in this tremendous narration of the Messenger of Allah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, here we see Allah, his attribute of a satr, of covering and hiding, and also his attribute of ghufran, of forgiveness, ya ikhwan, of forgiving, of maghfirah. If only the believers, ikhwan, would cover their own affair as Allah has covered it, as we see in the likes of this narration, so they will be forgiven by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَيُعْتَ كِتَابْ حَسَنَاتِهِ. And then he will be given from his books of good deeds. وَأَمَّا الْكَافِرُ. But after the disbeliever, فَيُقُولَ الْأَشْهَادُ. After the disbeliever, the kafir, then the witnesses will be brought against him. هؤلاء الذين كذبوا, and they will say regarding him, these are the ones who lied on their Lord. هؤلاء الذين كذبوا على ربهم, these are the ones who lied upon their Lords. ألا لعنة الله على الظالمين. Is not the curse of Allah upon those who oppress? Is not the curse of Allah upon the oppressors? This narration in the Quran collected by Al-Bukhari وإمام مسلم في صحيحيهما. The attribute Ikhwan of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala of a satr, of the covering of the sins. The attribute of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala of maghfirah. Here we see the connection again. How many narrations can we bring with this connection? Kullu ummati mu'afa illa al-mujahirin. All of my ummah forgiven except those who expose themselves. Connection between satr and maghfirah. Wal-afu from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If only the people would hasten to the forgiveness of their Lord and cover their sins. For what is it in for you? In the uncovering of sins. Of what benefit is it? Except humiliation in this worldly life. And humiliation for al-akhirah. In front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not only have we been commanded. As we see in these narrations that we have mentioned. The command of covering one's own sins. But it's from the way of the believers. And the manhaj of Islam. And the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To cover the sins of the believers. For those who cover their own sins. We're not now discussing those who are mujahab al-fisq. Those who are open sinners. And we will discuss the affair in the coming weeks, Ikhwan. We have not left that matter off. We will give every affair its right, bi-ithnillahi tabarak wa ta'ala. As Ahl al-Sunnah yadhkur ma lahum wa ma alayhim. Ahl al-Sunnah mentions what is for them and what is against them. Amma ahl al-bid'ah fa yadhkur ma lahum wa yaskutu amma alayhim. As for the people of innovation, then they mention what is for them and remain quiet in that which is against them. The Messenger of Allah Muhammad ﷺ, Ikhwan, he commanded with the satr ala ahl al-ma'asi. He commanded with the covering of the faults of the individuals and the likes of this for those who cover their affair. An Abi Huraira, on the authority of Abu Huraira, radiallahu anhu, anna Rasulullah ﷺ qal, la yasru abdan abdan fi dunya. إِلَّا سَطْرُهُ اللَّهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. In the authentic narration collected by Imam Muslim in his Sahih, on the authority of Abu Huraira, ya Ikhwan, that there is not a slave who covers the sin of a believer in this worldly life except that Allah will cover his sin on يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. So what happens now? An individual comes upon the sin of his brother or his sister. Comes upon the sin of his brother or his sister. Her brother or her sister. What do they do with that sin? Do they rush out? Do they hasten to rush out to make that sin known? Are they from those individuals, ya Ikhwan, who hasten to make isha'at al-fa'isha fil ladhina amanu, who hasten to rush out to spread that sin amongst the believers? To bring that dhil, Ikhwan, the humiliation upon the believers. Are they happy and excited with the downfall of their brothers and their sisters? And we will bring, Ikhwan, a special section, inshallah ta'ala, in these classes of the narrations of the Messenger of Allah Muhammad wasallam of the impermissibility of rejoicing at the downfall of a believer. Who is happy at the downfall of a believer? Who loves that a believer is humiliated? Who loves that a believer, yeah, Ikhwan, falls into something that is haram against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Who loves that for their brother? Who loves that for their sister? Who rejoices at it? Except one, Ikhwan, who has a disease in their heart. Iwallahi, Ikhwan, to rejoice at the downfall of your brother and your sister. To rejoice at the zalat, their slippings and their fallings. To rejoice and to be happy about them. The one who does so has a disease in their chest. Know for certainty, Ikhwan, that the one who rejoices and is happy and who celebrates the likes of these matters has a disease in their chest. And we will further elaborate on that. Bi-ithnillahi tabarak wa ta'ala. But look at what the Prophet ﷺ says. That the one who covers that fault when it reaches them. Who covers it with their thawbas. We'll find in the narration from Abu Bakr as-Siddiq. He said, if only I could have hidden the people of sin with my thawb. If I could have covered them with my thawb, I would have done so. If only they would follow the way of Abu Bakr as-Siddiq. As the narration comes in the Musannaf of Abdul Razzaq. Abu Bakr said, if I could just cover them with my thawb just to hide them from the people, then I would have done so. Why don't we talk like Abu Bakr as-Siddiq? Why is it that we're on the opposite side of the spectrum, pulling the sheets off of them, pulling the covers off of them, pulling back the curtains, trying to show the mankind, trying to show the people, the slippings of the people. This was not the way of Abu Bakr as-Siddiq. It was not the way of Umar ibn al-Khattab. It was not the way of the Messenger of Allah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It is not the way of the Sabir of the Mu'mineen. It is not the way of the believers, Ikhwan. Rather, Ikhwan, is the way of the people of evil and the way of transgression, as we will continue to elaborate bi idhnillahi tabarak wa ta'ala. عن ابن عمر رضي الله عنهما أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال المسلم أخو المسلم. The Muslim is the brother of another Muslim. لا يظلمه, he does not oppress him. ولا يسلمه, ومن كان في حاجة أخيه كان الله في حاجته. And whoever gives help to a brother in need, then Allah will give aid to that person who gives aid to his brother. وَمَنْ فَرَّجَ عَنْ مُسْلِمٍ كُرَّبَةٍ. And whoever removes some difficulty, some distress upon a believer in this worldly life, فَرَّجَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ كُرَّبَةٍ مِنْ كُرَّبَاتِ يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ. And Allah will remove some distress from the distresses on the Day of Judgment. وَمَنْ سَتَرَ مُسْلِمًا سَتَرَهُ اللَّهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. And whoever covers the faults of a Muslim, Allah will cover their faults on Yawm al-Qiyamah. Who from amongst us does not desire that Allah covers our faults? Pay attention, Ikhwan. Pay attention, Akhawat. For indeed, all of us will face Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do we not love? Do we not have hope that Allah will cover our sins? As one of the Salaf said, you despise your brother. You disdain your brother and sister for what you think about them. And you love yourself and you know what you do. How many of us, Ikhwan, if we were followed up? How many of us, those, if we were exposed for that which we do in the darkness of our homes? How many of us, Ikhwan, would be embarrassed and humiliated? So now just think of the chance of having those sins hidden from you, from being covered from you, and the condition and the way to do so is to cover a believer in this worldly life. Cover a believer that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will cover you. We are mu'minun bi'ithnillahi ta'ala, believers, Ikhwan. And therefore, when we hear these narrations, we hold on to them with our molar teeth. We bite down upon them with our molar teeth, Ikhwan, and we don't let go of them for anything. This is our life. In the sunnah, in hayatun lana, is a life for us. These are not stories that we're just reading to one another. These are not some tales of the ancients. These are not just some words of wisdom. This is revelation from above the seven heavens, Ikhwan. If you cover the believer in this worldly life, Allah will cover you on Yawm al-Qiyamah. Who does not want that for themselves, Ya Ikhwan? And if I asked anyone in this room right now, who would want them for themselves? Everyone in this room would say they would want them for themselves. Then I asked you, then why don't you cover your believing brother and sister so as to bring about that covering from Allah on Yawm al-Qiyamah? This is the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Ikhwan. وعن أبي برزة الأسلمي أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال يا معشر من آمن بلسانه ولم يدخل الإيمان قلبه لا تغتابوا المسلمين ولا تتبعوا عوراتهم فإنه من اتبع عوراتهم يتبع الله عورته ومن يتبع الله عورته يفضحه ولو في بيته. This narration, Ikhwan, is collected by Abu Dawood al-Sijistani in his Sunan and authenticated by Shaykh al-Albani rahimahullah ta'ala, where he mentions, O people who say they believe upon their tongues, but iman is not entered into their hearts, do not make ghibah of the Muslims. Do not backbite the Muslims. And when the companions, Ikhwan, when they asked the Messenger of Allah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam al-ghibah, what the said, أتدري ما الغيبة؟ The Prophet ﷺ asked him, excuse me, what is, do you know what غيبة is? And the Prophet ﷺ said, ذكرك أخاك بما يقرأ. It is mentioning about your brother or your sister that which they dislike. So the companions are quite always concerned with understanding the affairs of the sunnah of the Messenger of Muhammad ﷺ asked, ولو كان فيه ما أقول. What if what we are saying is true? The Prophet ﷺ said, if it is true, then you have committed غيبة against them. And if it is not true about them, فَقَدْ بَهَتَّهُ. And if it is not true, then you have slandered and maligned them. And in the Prophet ﷺ, he says, do not backbite the Muslims and do not follow up the faults of the believers. Do not follow up the faults of the Muslims. For whoever follows up the faults of the Muslims, Allah will follow up their faults. And whoever Allah follows up their faults, Allah will expose them, even if they're in the innermost portions of their home. And namima, ikhwan, is namima. Whether you commit namima on your computer screen in the basement of your home. Some people think because they're in the darkness of their home, in the basement, hiding like the shaitan that Sheikh Luhaydan mentioned about them. Hiding in their basement like a shaitan where no one can see them. They believe that they are making this namima and no one sees them. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sees you. Allah is a raqib alaykum. Allah is a watcher over you. And Allah sees what you are doing in the darkness of your basement. Allah sees what you are doing in the darkness of your rooms. Allah sees you before the glow of your computer screens, backbiting and slandering the believers. And Allah will expose you, even if you do that matter in the innermost portions of your home. Exposing the believers, slandering the believers, backbiting the believers. We are those who believe in what Allah has said. We are those who believe in what His Messenger has said. And we believe that Allah is going to expose you, either in this life or in the next life, for that which you are doing in the innermost portions of your home, by Allah's permission. And He said, whoever follows up the affairs of the believers, Allah will follow up his sins and his affairs and will expose him, even if he does those matters in the innermost portions of your home. Whispering on the corners across the street. Whispering in the barber shops. Whispering in the homes. This ikhwan, Allah will expose you no matter how low you whisper. As indeed Allah is all hearing in that which you say. Allah hears all that you say. And the angels are recording what you are saying. And Allah is recording what you are whispering. And know for certainty, ikhwan, that no one from the believers will be harmed in this life, except that they will be given back that which they were harmed on Yawm al-Qiyamah. And we hope to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ikhwan, that these individuals repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in the next lessons, we will talk about what their repentance requires. Bi'idhnillahi tabarak wa ta'ala. Wa an Mu'awiyah ibn Abi Sufyan, anna Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qal, innaka in ittaba'ata awrat an-nas, afsadtahum. Al-Kitta and Tufsidahum. Then this authentic narration, authenticated by the ulama from the likes of them, Shaykh al-Albani, that Muawiyah ibn Abi Sufyan, he said, that the Messenger of Allah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, indeed the one who follows up the faults of the believers has destroyed them. Allahu Akbar. The one who follows up the faults of the believers has destroyed them or is about to destroy them. وقال Abu Darda. Abu Darda, he said regarding this narration, يعني كلمة سمعها معاوية من رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم نفع الله بها. This is a word that Muawiyah heard from the Messenger of Allah Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم that he benefited from. وعن عباد بن صامت أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال وحوله عصابة جماعة من أصحابه. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was standing one day, أخوان, and around him were a number of his companions, a group of his companions. And the Prophet ﷺ said, بَايِعُونِ عَلَىٰ أَنْ لَا تُشْرِكُوا بِاللَّهِ شَيْئًا. Pledge allegiance to me that you will not associate any partners in worship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَا تَسْرِقُوا, and you will not steal. وَلَا تَزْنُوا, and you will not commit fornication. وَلَا تَقْتُلُوا أَوْلَادَكُمْ, and you will not kill your children. وَلَا تَأْتُونَ بِبُهْتَانٍ تَفْتَرُونَهُ بَيْنَ أَيْدِيكُمْ وَأَرْجُلُكُمْ, and that you will not commit buhtan, any falsehood in the likes of this. وَلَا تَعْصُوا فِي مَعْرُوفٍ, and you will not commit transgression. فَمَنْ وَفَّ مِنْكُمْ فَأَمْرُهُ إِلَى اللَّهِ وَمَنْ أَصَّابَ مِنْ ذَلِكَ شَيْئًا فَعُوقِبَ فِي الدُّنْيَا فَهُوَ كَفَّارَةٌ لَهُ. So as for those who are free from the likes of these matters and his affairs with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and whoever falls into something from these things and they are punished in this worldly life, then it is an expiation for them. وَمَنْ أَصَّابَ مِنْ ذَلِكَ شَيْئًا ثُمَّ سَتَرَهُ اللَّهُ. And as for those who fall into something from this and Allah covers it, فَهُوْ إِلَى اللَّهِ إِنْ شَاءَ عَفَىٰ عَنْهُ وَإِنْ شَاءَ عَقَبَهُ. And if they fall into this and Allah covers them, if Allah wills, He will forgive them and pardon them. And if He wills, then He will punish them. فَبَيَعْنَاهُ عَلَىٰ ذَٰلِكَ. And we pledge allegiance to the Messenger of Allah Muhammad upon this. And as we see in the narration, Ya Ikhwan, that the companions made bay'ah to the Messenger of Allah Muhammad upon that. And in that narration was the fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala perhaps will cover from those affairs of thievery and fornication and the likes of that and the killing of the children and that which is mentioned in the narration of the Messenger of Allah Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. As for Ikhwan, as we have said, and again, we will elaborate in much detail on the issue of those who openly expose their sins. We will elaborate on this, Ikhwan, as there is for them a statement. And with kulli maqal maqam, fi kulli maqam maqal, there is a time and place for everything and a statement in every affair. And we will discuss that matter in some totality and some detail, bi'ithnillahi ta'ala. And perhaps these lessons will go longer than the 4 weeks that I originally mentioned, as there's a lot of information surrounding it, Ikhwan. And we hope to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to try to do the issue its right and its justice, bi'ithnillahi tabarak wa ta'ala. Qal ibn Hajar, ذكر النووي رحمه الله تعالى إمام النووي he said أن من جاهر بفسقه أو بدعته أو بدعته جاز ذكره بما جاهر به دون ما لم يجاهر به. And then was mentioned, Ikhwan, regarding the mujahara, those who openly commit these acts, yani those who openly commit acts of fisk and innovation, that we hold them accountable for that which they have done openly, meaning that we mention those affairs amongst the people, and that which has not been openly mentioned, yani, then that is that which we do not mention amongst the people. And inshallah ta'ala, Ikhwan, so that no one confuses what we are mentioning tonight with regarding the covering of the faults of the believers, those who spread innovation. That is not what is intended by these narrations, barakallahu fikum. For in the affair of innovation, Ikhwan, in the affair of yani, refuting innovation is protection of the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we will show, Ikhwan, in the coming lessons, the difference between the two. Yani, beyond the shadow of a doubt, we will show the difference of the two, and we will show yani, that innovation is more beloved to shaytan than ma'asiyah. We'll talk about this, inshallah ta'ala, Ikhwan. We're going to give, inshallah ta'ala, some detail to the likes of that matter as well. And we will show, Ikhwan, that no one is confused regarding this matter of innovation. The innovations, Ikhwan, are refuted, and that they are mentioned amongst the people so as to be refuted, barakallahu fikum. And now we see, Ikhwan, from some of the actions of the Messenger of Allah, Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Kana Rasul, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Prophet sallam was, Ikhwan, if one of the companions, for example, would fall into some error or like this, some mistake, the Prophet sallam would not expose them yani al mala in front of the people like that. Rather, he would ascend the minbar, for example, and he would say, "What is with a people?" He would not say their names, but "What is with a people who do such and such?" For example, but he would not yusarrah bi asma'ihim, but he would not yani specify their names upon the minbar. An Anas ibn Malik. On the authority of Anas ibn Malik, radiallahu anhu, anna Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qal, ma bal aqwam yarfa'un absarahum ila as-sama'i fi salatihim. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ikhwan, noticed that some of the people were looking up to the sky in their salat. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not get up and say, so-and-so was doing such and such, and so-and-so by his name was doing such and such. But rather he would say, what is wrong with a people? What is wrong with a people? Or what is with a people? That they look to the heavens, yani they look to the sky when they are in their prayers. Hatta qala, until he said, لَيَنْتَهِيَنَّ عَنْ ذَلِكَ أَلِتَخْتَفَنَّ أَبَصَارُهُمْ. And they will either stop doing this, or Allah will seize and snatch their sight from them. And this is in Bukhari, Ikhwan. The narration is collected by Imam al-Bukhari in his Sahih. So here we see in this narration, Ikhwan, the benefit, as the ulama have mentioned, that the Messenger of Allah, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, would not make tasrih of the asma' of his sahaba, of their names, in the likes of these errors that they may have made regarding these matters. Rather, he would say, what is with the people who do such and such? وعن أبي حميد الساعدي قال استعمل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم رجل من بني أسد على الصدقة. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم placed one of the people from Bani Asad upon the صدقة. فلما قدم قاس, when he came, he said to the people, وهذا أهدي لي, يعني هذا لكم, وهذا أهدي لي, this is for you and this is for me. In front of the people, he did this. فقام النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم على المنبر. So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم went upon the minbar and he praised Allah. ثم قال ما بال العامل, what is with a people, with a person that we send to do something. فيأتي فيقول هذا, and he said this and that. فهلا جلس في بيت أبيه وأمه فلينظر أهدي له أم لا. It would have been better that the person would stay in their home and say, this is what I'm going to give to so-and-so, and this is what I will give to myself, instead of doing it in front of the people. In other words, Prophet ﷺ never got up and said, so-and-so by his name did such and such. As-salamu rahmatullah. وَقِيلَ لِإِبْنِ مَسْعُودِ. It was said to Ibn Mas'ud, رَضِ لَهُ عَنْهُ, هَذَ فُلَانًا تَقْتُرْ لِحْيَتُهُ خَمْرًا. فَقَالَ عَبْدُ اللَّهِ إِنَّ قَدْ نُهِينَا عَنَ التَّجَسُّسِ. ولكن إذ إن يظهر لنا شيء نأخذ به. This narration, Ikhwan, is so filled with tremendous narration, so many benefits, that we have a special section also regarding a tajassus, spying on the Muslims, spying on one another, which we find upon the people. And we'll bring this narration at that point with some of the kalam of the ulama from them, Shaykh al-Uthaymeen, bi-idhnillahi tabarak wa ta'ala. But in this narration, Ibn Mas'ud, someone came and they said, so-and-so has a wine dripping from his beard. No one saw him drinking the wine, but there was wine dripping from his beard, or drizzles of wine in his beard. And Abdullah ibn Umar said, what, ikhwan? Indeed, we were prohibited from spying on one another. If a companion says we were prohibited, who prohibited them? The Messenger of Allah Muhammad sallallahu alaihi. The wording here that the actual doer is not mentioned, but rather he says nuhina, we were prohibited. They were prohibited by who? Who prohibits? Allah or His Messenger. Allah or His Messenger. Allah and His Messenger. So therefore they were prohibited by Allah in the Quran, where Allah says what? La tajassasu. Allah says, do not spy on one another. What did the Prophet ﷺ say in the authentic narration? La tajassasu. Do not spy upon one another. As we will bring in the narration, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. Nuhina an tajassus. We have been prohibited from spying. So who are we now, ikhwan? Are you more knowledgeable? And you have more taqwa? More fear of Allah than Ibn Mas'ud? The companion of the Messenger of Allah, Muhammad ﷺ. Here is Abu Musa al-Ash'ari. A scholar from the companions in his own right, seeing those people making dhikr in the masjid in a manner that was not taught by the Messenger of Allah Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And what did he do? Didn't say a word. He went to the house of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud to wait to see what he would say. So who from amongst us now thinks that they have more understanding in Allah's religion than Abdullah ibn Mas'ud? So now you're going to make tajassus? Now you're going to spy on the believers? Now you're going to investigate? Listen to this word. We're investigating them. Trying to find out if they're really snitches. Trying to find out if they really committed homosexuality. We want to really find out if they commit fornication. We're investigating them. Ibn Mas'ud said, Nuhina an tajassus. We were prohibited from spying on the Muslims. The man had drizzles of wine in his beard. If we see someone doing a crime or we catch them in the crime, then we take them in accordance to that crime. Who amongst us now thinks they have better understanding than Abdullah ibn Mas'ud? Wallahi, ikhwan, it is better for us to follow the way of the believers, sabil al-mu'mineen, and not to put ourselves forward before these tremendous companions of the Messenger of Allah, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who helped establish and spread for us the minhaj of Islam, the methodology of a Salafi and al-Islam. In another authentic narration, ikhwan, collected by Abdul Razak and his Musannif. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud again, ikhwan. Ashrafa ala darihi bil Kufa. That Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, ikhwan, came out to the door of his home, sat in the doorway of his home. And then a group of people, ikhwan, gathered around him. Faqala, and he said to the people, Man ja'a yastaftina. فَلَيَجْلِسْ نُفْتِهِ. Whoever came to seek fatwa, whoever came to ask a question, then ask it and we will give you an answer. And then he said, إِخْوَانَ وَمَنْ جَاءَ يُخَاصِمْ فَلْيَقْعَدْ حَتَّى نَقْضِي بَيْنَهُ وَبَيْنَ خَصْمِهِ. And whoever comes with some dispute between him and another person, then sit until we have ruled between you and the one you are disputing with. And then he said, إِخْوَانَ نَعَمْ. So Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, ikhwan, as he was at the door of his home, sitting amongst the people of Kufa, as a band or a party of people gathered around him, and he said, whoever comes to seek fatwa, to ask a question, then ask it and we will answer it. If Allah wills, inshallah. And whoever's come to clear up some disputation, some dispute between him and another, then we will clear up that dispute if Allah wills. وَمَنْ جَاءَ يُرِيدُ أَنْ يُطْلِعَنَا عَلَىٰ عَوْرَةٍ قَدْ سَتَرَهَا اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِ فَلْيَسْتَتِرْ بِسَتْرِ اللَّهِ. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, he said, ya ikhwan, but whoever comes to us hoping to give us and show us or expose to us some sin or some fault that Allah has covered, then let him cover with the covering of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then let him cover that sin with the cover of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't say it to us. Don't mention it to us. Whoever wants to ask a question, then let him ask, and we will try to answer it. Whoever comes with some disputation between them and another, then let them come so we can try to make the disputation.
But whoever has done some sin and Allah has covered, then let them remain under the cover of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then he continued, he said after this, Ikhwan, وَلِيَقْبَلْ عَافِيَتَهُ, and let him accept Allah's pardon and forgiveness. وَلِيُسَرِّ تَوْبَتَهُ, and let him also return his tawbah. إِلَى الَّذِي يَمْلِكُ مَغْفِرَتَهَا, let him return his forgiveness to the one who can forgive him, the one who possesses the ability to forgive him. فَإِنَّا لَا نَمْلِكُ مَغْفِرَتَهَا, because we cannot forgive him. Allahu Akbar. We do not have the ability to forgive this individual. He says, وَلَاكِنْ نُقِيمَ لَحِ الْحَدِ, but rather all we can do is give them the punishment. All we can do is give them the punishment, وَنَمْسَكَ عَلَيْهِ بَعَارُهُ, and stop them from doing what they are doing. But listen to what Ibn Mas'ud said, Ikhwan. Warn them before they even started with their questions. If anyone wants to start talking about some sin that Allah has covered, then let them cover that sin with the cover of Allah, and let them accept Allah's forgiveness. And that is also collected, Ikhwan, by Abdul Razak and his Musannif, and Anas ibn Malik. And Anas ibn Malik, ya Ikhwan, radiallahu anhu, an Salih ibn Karz, annahu jaa bi jariya lahu zanat ila al-Hakim ibn Ayyub. Qala, fabayna ana jalisun idha jaa Anas ibn Malik, fajalasa faqal ya Salih, ma hadhihi al-jariya allati ma'ak, qultu jariya li bagat. فأردت أن أرفعها للإمام ليقيم عليها الحد فقال لا تفعل رد جاريتك واتق الله واستر عليها قلت ما أنا بفاعل قال لا تفعل وأطعني فلم يزل يراجعني حتى رددتها أخرجه عبد الرزاق في المصنف. And he mentions Ikhwan the narration upon Anas ibn Malik collected by عبد الرزاق in his مصنف that Salih ibn Karz that he said that Anas said that that Salih ibn Karz came to him with a young girl or a girl who had committed zina. And he came to Al-Hakim ibn Ayyub. And he said that while we were sitting, and he said, O Salih, why have you come with this young girl? Why is she with you? And he said, she has committed such and such an act. And I want to take her affair to the imam so as that he can place the punishment upon her. And then Anas said to him, Ya Akhwan, La taf'al. Don't do it. Don't do this. رُدَّ جَارِتَكَ, take her back, return with your slave girl, or return with your servant girl, and fear Allah and cover her sin. Fear Allah and cover her sin. So he said, قُلْتُ مَا أَنَا بِفَعَلٍ, no, I'm not going to do that, I'm taking her. And Anas continued to say, لَا تَفْعَلْ, don't do it, أَطِعْنِي, listen to me, don't do it. And then he said, and he continued to say it to me, and say it to me, until I returned with my slave girl, and I didn't take her before the ruler to be punished. This Ikhwan is the statement of Anas ibn Mas'ud as we find in this narration. Qala Mis'ar, رحمه الله تعالى, من أهدى إلي عيوبي في ستر بيني وبينه, فإن النصيحة في الملأ تقريع بهجة المجالس. الله أكبر. Then Mis'ar ibn Qaddam, he said, Ya Ikhwan, that if only what the people would give to me my عيوب, my faults or my errors between me and them in private. Between me and them in private. And he was satr by hiding it between me and them. For indeed this fadiha, as we'll say fadiha, this exposing in front of the people, is that which destroys the splendor of the majalis, of the sittings and the gatherings. Allahu Akbar, ya Ikhwan. So therefore, let us not be from those who destroy the gatherings, ya Ikhwan, but let us be from those who give nasiha. Wa qala ba'du salaf, and some of the salaf said, adraktu aqwamin lam yakun lahum uyub. I met a people who didn't have these faults. فَذَكْرُ عُيُوبَ النَّاسِ, so they began to mention the faults of others. فَذَكْرَ النَّاسِ عُيُوبٍ لَهُمْ, so when they mentioned their faults, people started talking about their faults. So when they started talking about the sins of others, others started talking about their sins. وَأَدْرَكْتُ أَقْوَامٍ كَانَتْ لَهُمْ عُيُوبٍ, and then I met a people who had sins. فَكَفُوا عَنْ عُيُوبِ النَّاسِ, but they remained quiet and hid the sins of the people. وَنُسِيَتْ عُيُوبُهُمْ, and then therefore their sins were forgotten. Because Allah covers the sins of those who cover the sins of their brothers. قال الوزير الصالح, and this was mentioned, Ikhwan, in جامع العلوم والحكم. قال الوزير الصالح لأحد الوزراء الصالحين, and one of the righteous of the past said to someone, he said, من يأمر بالمعروف وينهى عن المنكر اجتهد أن تستر العصاة, and تستر العصاة. For those who enjoin the good and forbid the evil, strive to cover the sins of the sinners. فإن ظهور معاصيهم عيب في أهل الإسلام. For indeed the exposing of their sins brings about fault and blame upon the people of Al-Islam. We mentioned this last week, Ya Ikhwan, from the Masawi, from the negative aspects of this uncovering and the spreading and exposing of sins amongst the believers, is that which humiliates the community. And so as we said, the Christians, they say, why would we want to be Muslims? Are they fornicating and adulterating, and and the leaders running around sleeping with this one and that one? We can get that in the church. So this, as we have said, Ikhwan, is that which happens and that which causes aibs, he said, Allah al-Islam, upon the people of al-Islam. وقال عوف الأحمسي كان يقال من سمع بفاحشة فأفشاها كان فيها كالذي بدأها. عوف, Ikhwan, he said, الأحمسي, he said, whoever, whoever hears of a particular fahisha, a sin or transgression, he spreads that sin and transgression, then he is equal in sin with the one who began it. So now I don't think because now you tell somebody what you heard, I heard so-and-so slept with so-and-so. Don't think now because you didn't start the rumor that you're not as equal in sin. You are as guilty as the one who started with it. And there's also the statement of Ali ibn Abi Talib as well, Ya Ikhwan. Because it is isha'azul fahisha fil ladhina amanu. Because it goes back to the ayat that we're going to spend one whole lesson on, inshallah ta'ala, spreading the sins of the people, the stories of sins amongst the believers. So the one who starts it and the one who spreads it, they are equal in sin. So the person says, well, I didn't start it. I didn't intend this. I was just telling somebody what I heard. Namima, you're an imam. You're an imam. You're a tail carrier. And we'll tell you to your face, you're an imam. And we'll treat you like an imam. You're an imam. You're a tail carrier. And the narration of the tail carrier is not accepted. And I mentioned at the end, inshallah, before we take questions, we got a question to our Sheikh Muhammad ibn Hadi this week. And alhamdulillah, the Sheikh expounded or answered this question that we were asked last week. Barakallahu feekum. Tell you, and we'll end with this. Yani, the benefit of the satr of the faults of the people. And from that which has been recorded in the Sunan of Abi Dawud, Ikhwan and Aisha, authenticated by Sheikh Al-Albani, rahimah ta'ala, where the Prophet sallam said, Aqeelu dhawil hay'at atharatuhum illa al-hudud. Authentic narration, authenticated by Sheikh Al-Albani, where the Prophet sallam said, cover and hide the faults of the people of status amongst you. The people who are the noted ones from amongst you, your teachers and your leaders and the likes of that. The Prophet ﷺ said, strive to pardon the likes of them, except that which is to be given in the punishment to the ruler. Now, in Aun al-Ma'abud, which is the explanation of the Sunan of Abi Dawud, Azim Abadi, he says, ma'an al-hadith, u'rifu an ashab al-muru'at wal-khisal al-hamida. Cover and pardon those individuals who are known amongst you to be from the leaders and the righteous and the honorable and those who have praiseworthy characteristics. Yani dhil wujuh. Those who are known and have status amongst the people. Alladhina la yujahiduna bil ma'asi. Those who not openly expose their sins. We're not talking about open sinners now. Those who hide their sins. Walakin taqa'a minhum ba'd az-zallat. But rather they are from those who hide from amongst their sins. Cover those affairs as is found in the narration of the Messenger of Allah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And I mentioned to you, Ikhwan, regarding what was mentioned to us last week. Well, what about these individuals whose names just keep coming up? Every time we turn around, their names are in some namima, or their names are in some stories that they did this and they did that. Every time we turn around, it's the same names doing the same stuff. Well, the last time we checked, Ikhwan, the Messenger of Allah Muhammad sallam said, al-baynatu al-mudda'i. The proof is upon the one who makes the claim. 100 claims, 200 claims, 300 claims, 5 years of claims. The proof is upon the one who makes the claim. And the last time I checked, and I'm not very good at math, 100 claims, zero proof, 100 times zero equals zero. The last time I checked. Barakallahu feekum. So therefore, Ikhwan, the individual who says, why do their names keep coming up? Do we say the same thing regarding the Shia, the Rafid, that's until this day of ours, still slander our mother Aisha and say our mother Aisha committed that evil act? Wali'adhu billah. Centuries, 1400 years later, and they're still saying the same thing. So do we understand your statement in this light? That because someone continues to say it over and over and over, even though it has been refuted, even though there was no proof, that just because of that now, yani, as the old saying goes, وَتَحْتَ دُخَانِي تَرُجُّ نَيْرَانِي. Where there's smoke, there's fire. We're not upon that methodology, Ikhwan. That is not our affair. تحت دخاني ترج نيراني. Where there's smoke, there's fire. لا يا إخوان, where there's دليل, where there's proof and evidences, there's fire. Otherwise, keep your hand off the alarm. Keep your hand off the fire alarm, barakallahu fikum. So we mentioned this, إخوان, and we also mentioned, after the question last week, regarding the one who makes halaf, who swears by Allah, that he will not tell someone who, you know, someone comes to you and they say, so-and-so said such and such about you, or so-and-so told me such and such, but they made me swear by Allah, or I swore by Allah that I would not mention that to the people. We got that question to Sheikh Muhammad bin Hadi, and the Sheikh said, first and foremost, the very foundation of it is error. It's very awesome, its very foundation is error, because the one who comes to you is an imam. The one who comes to you with the statement of hiding the person, he himself is an imam. He's a tail carrier. And the Shaykh said, who are mufsid, and he is one who corrupts between the relations of the people. So therefore, I'm not even interested in who told you anyway. You an imam. I don't even care who told you. I don't want to know his name and don't care because you an imam. I know your name and you're an imam. That's how we have to begin to deal with these individuals, Ikhwan. If we begin to deal with these individuals in this way, they will not find any refuge. No port in the storm, Ikhwan Azza said. No shelter, no covering. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide them or swell their tongues. Ameen. So we'll end here. If the brothers have any questions, we'll take them now. If the sisters have anything, send it over, inshallah ta'ala. You're covering your sin, barakallah. You're covering the fault, barakallah. There's some kalam from Sheikh Ibn Baz on that. Sheikh Ibn Baz elaborates on that topic that you're talking about right now. Specifically, those who are brought before the Hakim, Muslim, the Muslim ruler, the Muslim judge, regarding the first. Let me bring that kalam from Sheikh Ibn Baz next week so as to give some elaboration on that, inshallah ta'ala.
I don't know if you touched on this topic, this might have brought it up last week, but what type of advice you have for the sisters who have close companions that expose the
thoughts
of their husband?
Allahu Akbar.
And
Allahu Akbar. That's an excellent question. The brother, he asked, regarding a brother who has a wife, and his wife has companions from those who expose the sins of their husbands and the faults of their husbands, what should he do regarding his wife? We say, ya Ikhwan, first and foremost, in all that we have mentioned, yani, regarding these matters, and we mentioned in the khutbah, yani, the other week when we were here, not this Friday that passed, but the Friday before, we mentioned the Prophet ﷺ said, should I not inform you who are the best from amongst you? And the companion said, Bala ya Rasulullah. And the Prophet ﷺ said, إِذَا الرُّؤُوا ذُكِرَ اللَّهِ. Those that when they are seen, then they are reminded of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Or Allah is remembered. And Allah is remembered. أَلَا أُخْبِرُكُمْ بِشِرَارِكُمْ. Should I not show you who are the worst from amongst you? And he said, and the companion said, Bala ya Rasulullah. He said, those who go about and they mention the ani, they make namima or the namam, yani the one who makes the al-qalatu finnas or makes the speech regarding the faults and the sins of the people. So there is no question, Ikhwan, that from the worst of the people, yani are those who expose the faults of the believers. How much more now a wife in a husband's home exposing the faults and the sins of her husband to others? So it takes the very foundation of that which we mentioned before. She's an imam. She's a tail carrier. And that which destroys the honor of her own family now. The father of her children, perhaps. Her husband, who Allah has placed her under his care. Her imam in the house. And now she humiliates not only him, but herself. Because she has brought humiliation upon her own home. And why does she remain with the man that's so evil? If she spreads his sins and talks about his sins like that, why does she remain amongst them? At any rate, regarding this matter, then we advise our sisters to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to advise our husbands for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If there are some sins or some faults that she needs to raise so that she can, because she is oppressed. That is one thing. If she is oppressed, then let her go to the proper people. And let her go to the people who can give her her rights, who can strive to give her her rights. Let her ask from the scholars. Let her ask from the people who can get the question to the scholars. Let her go to the leaders of the community, the leaders of the people. Let her go to those individuals so as to get her rights, if that is the case. But all too often what we find is merely people like to talk about the sins of their husbands. Talk about this, my husband did this, my husband did that. And again, this is evil. This is namima. And we advise our brothers who know that their wives are doing this to command them not to keep company with the likes of those sisters. For them to advise those sisters first and foremost to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to cease and desist from what they are doing, from evil and transgression. And if they do not, then let them tell them, to let you tell your wives not to yani walk with those women. And I'll tell you why, Ikhwan. Shaykh Al-Uthaymeen said, من نم كلام الناس إليك نمه أو نم كلامك إلى غيرك. Whoever makes namima to you about what somebody else said, know for certainty they're talking about what you said to somebody else. Just the way of the human being. So now if that woman is making namima about her husband, you don't think she'll make namima about your wife and you? So you want to keep your wife away from somebody like that at all costs. At all costs. Better go love you. No. Yeah.
And then, what if the sister is calling this, is contacting your wife, posting a sihah?
What can your wife do? What can your wife do? What can she do? Let her go to the fas'alu ahla dhikr in kuntum la ta'lamun. Let her go to the people of knowledge. Let her go to the people who can actually do something about it. Barakallahu feek. Yani. It would make more sense now that if you want to go seek some advice, you go seek some advice for somebody who can actually do something about the situation. As opposed to somebody who is just going to give us some advice. Yani, perhaps a woman doesn't have any knowledge in the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and perhaps she gives her advice that is contrary, contradictory to the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You need to divorce him, child. Who knows what she might say? Allah almost died. Leave that, barakallahu feek. Nah, end it. Huh? Ar-rijal shaqaq an-nisa. The women and the men are twins, brothers and sisters. What is for them is what is against them. Nah, I'm sorry. An-nisa shaqaq an-rijal. Nah.
What is your opinion, but what is the
Muslim
women that are engaged in social media?
And those who know that their wives and their husbands are going on these websites and spreading this information, wallahi, they should be from those who tell them to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to tell them to fear. Some of you know what your husbands and wives are doing in these homes, Ikhwan, with these websites. Some of you know. Some of you know what your, some of you are coming in the room and your wives are pointing to the computer screen. Look what they're saying about Fulan from the callers. Look what they're saying about Fulan from the shuyukh. Some of you are witnessing this and engaging in it. Fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fi anfusikum. How can you be a leader of your home and you know your wife is doing the likes of this? Yeah, Ikhwan. Allah understand. Sometimes, sadly, it's the other way around. Go ahead, I'm sorry. We have an entire class on Facebook and social media and websites. Alhamdulillah, I keep saying how many classes we have. We may be going to next summer, barakallahu feek. But the ulama have given us a number of advices regarding the internet. And I'm going to read all of them, inshallah ta'ala. As many as I can read, bi'idhnillahi ta'ala, from them, Sheikh Urbaid, from them, Sheikh Muhammad Bazmu, our brother Anwar, Ya'ani ibn Arif, Hafidhullah ta'ala, he translated. Very, is Ahmed or Sheikh Muhammad? Sheikh Ahmed Bazmu, a very beneficial yani fatwa regarding Facebook and the evils of Facebook. We have some fatwa, some kalam from Sheikh Rabi' and others regarding this affair. So we'll talk about that inshallah ta'ala in some detail at that point. Na'am, ghayruhu. Hey, na'am. Wudud. Why is he accusing them? And accusing them to who? When we talk about the permissible times of ghibah, we'll discuss that. There are, permissible times to actually go and mention a crime that was committed against you, right? But to who? That's why I asked you to who.
Now, when someone, for example, now, because brothers think now that someone does something to one of us, and when we say that there are certain instances where it's permissible to make ghibah if you are oppressed, for example. So a person may think that that means you can go now, go on the internet and type about somebody oppressed you. That means you go to the proper authorities. So even with that statement, and be patient, inshallah ta'ala. I'm going to deal with that in detail, inshallah ta'ala. Be patient, because there's a time and place for that, for certain people that are went to, and a time for that affair. But in instance, if there's no proof, then what will one do? The Prophet said, "Al-bayyina al-mudda'i." The proof is upon the one who makes the claim. So if you can't prove anything, why even? What are you making the claim for? Barakallahu fi. Now, other than that, I'll tell you, we'll end here, inshallah ta'ala. Next Saturday, we'll continue. Barakallahu fi.